So we would stay after school super late to like 6, both of us. And I'd see Mike doing his homework. And it was chemistry. It was pretty hard. So I'd wander over and I'd be like, Mike, let me teach you some shortcuts how to do this faster. And so I'd teach him and I'd sit there and talk to him. And then by the end of the lesson, Mike learned, but I feel like I learned more from Mike. Not about chemistry, but about truck racing. So I learned how it's better than NASCAR, and how brothers in it, and I thought it was pretty cool. So this would go on, and I see him doing his math homework, I'd come over and help him. And then I always ended up learning more from Mike than I did, than he did for me. Of course, it wasn't math, it was about fishing, hunting, and go-kart racing. So, I'm proud to introduce my friend and my teacher, my friend Lisa.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Bats. So, I wrote a speech.
Lasted for hours and it was still going. It was about 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. At this point, I was irritated and wanted it all to stop. While I was in my room, I heard a scream from my mom's bedroom. I jumped out of bed, rushed to my mom's room, and found my father standing over her while she was on the floor, still yelling at her. At that moment, I took action, and it was the moment that changed my life as I knew it. At the conclusion of the event, I received a phone call from a family friend. Before I could even say hello, he said, "You're coming to live with us, there's no buts." That family friend was Joe Culver. And right there, he helped me. Making me feel weird. I literally knew him my whole life. He's been there for me thinking. 3 days later, I was on a plane heading to my new home in Charlotte, North Carolina. It was tough leaving my family and friends behind in Miami, but I knew it was for the best, and I had a whole new opportunity to start over. Me and Joe, we would always joke with my mom about signing adoption papers because I was always over at his house hanging out with Jason. And she would always reply saying, "That's not funny." Well, after what happened, she had no choice. We still laugh about it today. After settling into my new home with my new family, questions kept circling in my head. Where am I going to go to school? Dates and days where we're sending you, they said. The next day, we dropped off Jason for his second week of school, Chip, whichever you call it. It was my very first time seeing the place. It was the same day I got to go to the school. I walked around to see where all the classes are at. I decided that, yeah, this place seems all right, let's try it. But I hadn't got to meet any students that day. 2 days later, I attended my first day at Davidson Day. And just like my first day at Miami Springs, I was accepting. I was expecting something similar to happen, like this guy probably beat me up, but he wasn't here. Something bigger. Within minutes of walking through the building, I was greeted by students left and right. I couldn't help but think to myself, something's really wrong here. But there wasn't. Davidson Day students were just being themselves. That day made me realize that every high school isn't like Miami Springs. It's only the public schools. 3 years, I attended Davidson Day and I had to overcome some challenges like doing no work in Miami Springs to actually putting in an effort here, trying to get good grades to pass. Within these 3 years, I have worked harder than I have ever had in my entire life. Davidson Day has taught me so much how far hard work can take you. The school didn't help me get to this point. It was the teachers and the faculty. I'd like to thank them for that. Mr. Wynn. Yeah, I know. I want to thank you for making me work harder in your class than I've ever had to work in any other class. Just thank you. I also want to thank Ms. Brown. You're probably going to hate me for saying this. I want to thank you for teaching me and Caleb the other word for kite. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Ask her after the speech. I'm pretty sure she won't tell you, but it's fun. I know we bothered you a lot with it last year, but I won't say that. I'd like to thank Miss Whitehead for helping me with math. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't ever been able to tackle fractions. I also want to thank Mr. Derry, not only for being an awesome advisor, but also being a great friend. I want to thank Mr. Lodge for giving me the name of Freebird. Well, and I also want to thank you for helping me after school when I couldn't figure out your chemistry in the fall. Also, Bass right there, also helping me out. Shout out to him. I want to thank Ms. Elliott for helping me with my college applications. Yeah, see? If it wasn't for you, I probably wouldn't be at my front door almost getting into college. And I'm sure that I'll hear back from them next week with an acceptance letter. Thanks to you. Most of all, I want to thank those two people sitting right there, Joe and Susan, aka Mom and Dad. I can't express how thankful I am for everything. without you, I wouldn't be standing up here giving a speech. The only way I can repay you guys is with love and lots of kindness. I love you both, and thank you for being my family. And as for Chip, Jason, Bubba, Cooter, whatever you want to call them, we've been friends ever since we were 2 years old. And 3 years later, we became brothers. It was one of the happiest moments of my life. And also, I want to thank you for being an awesome friend and an awesome brother. Couldn't have asked for anything better. I love you with all my heart. And we're going to miss him when he goes off to college next year. So I'm going to leave you guys with words of inspiration. If you ain't first, you're last. Just kidding. Don't ever pass up any opportunities that's given to you. Whether it be getting a better deal at Pizza Hut, or better food to take us to go watch whatever you watch. Because I took the best opportunity I had, and it paid off, and it did wonders for me.